Lance Roberts here, 3 minutes on Markets and Money. Yesterday, we discussed the issue of Trump wanting to get a trade deal done and what that would mean for the markets. And a trade deal would likely give the markets an advance up to about 3,300, keeping us well confined within this upward range that the market's been in. And we laid out the case for that advance, being the fact that the markets still have a tremendous amount of momentum with them. Stock buybacks are supportive, of course, the Fed rate cuts, and this whole idea that the bullish bias still well in tow here. But what happens if Trump doesn't get a deal done? And there's two real possibilities that this could occur. The first is an idea of no trade deal, but really no new tariffs. Now, the impact of that is simply the market will likely remain contained in this kind of trading range that we've been in for a while. One of the big issues is that the sectors that will perform the worst in this type of a situation, something that we laid out to our RIA Pro subscribers in March of 2018, is that trade wars don't play well with basic materials, industrials, international, and emerging markets. Importantly here, the economy is slowing down. All of our indicators are suggesting a slower economic environment. No trade deal with no new tariffs doesn't really fix the problem for the economy and likely will continue to see waning confidence. The worst possible outcome is no trade deal with new tariffs. In other words, Trump reinstates the tariffs back on December the 15th, see increases in other tariffs across the board. China retaliates with more tariffs. This could very well push the markets back to the December lows, potentially even setting new lows. And given the state of the economy and the weakness of it, could very well trigger a recessionary outbreak for the economy, dragging stock prices lower. The idea of a bear market certainly wouldn't be surprising. Looking at our long-term dynamics of the markets on a quarterly basis, the markets are more extended and overbought than at just about any point in history. So it's simply just a function of time until something trips up the markets, and the potential for a no-trade deal with more tariffs could very well be that idea. Understanding the risk, while there is a potential bias for the markets to rise to 3,300, there's also risk to the downside if something goes wrong. That's 3 minutes on Markets and Money. You can get this article along with all of our other YouTube videos, podcast, and more at realinvestmentadvice.com. We'll see you next time.